We're diving deep today on Asana versus Trello. By the end of this video, you'll know which one's better and which one to choose to make your life so much easier when it comes to managing projects. All right, let's do this. Hi, my name is Natalia and welcome back to my channel where I share super actionable ideas on content creation for entrepreneurs and creatives. If you're struggling with managing your day-to-day tasks and the to-do lists are piling up on your desk, you should seriously consider using a digital tool. There are so many options available on the market, but today I'm comparing some of the most popular free project management platforms, Trello and Asana. But which one should you choose? I use them both and I'm here to help. So both Asana and Trello have plenty of similarities. They're both free, great for teams and managing multiple projects, and they offer calendar view of your tasks. But as always, the devil's in the details. There are some key differences which I think make a whole lot of difference. Some say that Trello is more visually driven while Asana is much more kind of list oriented, but it's not entirely true. So make sure to watch the video to the very end and I'll show you how to make Asana a bit more visual. All right, so let's dive in. One, managing projects. In Trello, one project corresponds to one board and you have to switch between boards to access tasks, and it can have the same tasks assigned to a few different boards. This might be useful for a content calendar and Instagram project, for example. In Asana, all your projects are visible in the left panel, can be quickly switched between, and you can assign the same task to multiple projects. Trello allows for pretty much one view, which is the board view, which kind of emulates a classic real-life board with post-its as tasks. And as much as I absolutely love the visual approach, it's sometimes not ideal for different types of projects. Asana gives you the option of displaying your projects in board, list, and calendar views in their free plan and to switch between them freely. On top of that, you have the Progress tab, which lets you update your team on how the project is going. You can work from different views and focus on specific projects, have a Kanban or Scrum view for a big project management or sprint planning, and particular lists useful when focusing on a particular subject matter. This level of flexibility is fantastic, especially when you have team members used to different modes of operation. The teams can have their preferred format within their projects, which means if you have some people who worked on Trello before and prefer to use it, they can easily have a board view. Asana makes dealing with all of your tasks for multiple projects so much easier. The My Tasks tab is my absolute favorite feature they offer, and it simply pulls all of your tasks together in one place. You can view them as a list and have different sections, or you can see them on the calendar view, all color-coded and ready to get you going. And Trello now has the option to view all your tasks, but in my opinion, it's just not that efficient. Two, teamwork. Both Trello and Asana can be used to manage projects by teams, but Asana is more efficient and, of course, subjectively more aesthetically pleasing. You can add due dates and assign tasks to members on both the platforms. However, it is a bit more efficient in Asana. You can simply click to the right next to the task and assign a person to it, and that's you, done. Labeling can also be done on both, but Asana has more options since you can tag, label, and place tasks within sections and projects, which means there's more options as to what you can do. Plus, when you move tasks in board view, the sections automatically update on them. Three, usability and satisfaction. We all rely on user experience more than we think, and we design our websites for the customer's convenience, yet we might not consciously think about UX for ourselves that much. Well, that's where Asana excels. Completing tasks is much more satisfying in Asana than Trello. In Trello, you either move your tasks to a done section or archive the task by clicking in the corner and choosing that option. In Asana, you simply tick the task and there it goes. It's just like ticking tasks off on your handwritten to-do list. And the fact that it emulates that hands-on experience is just so satisfying. And from time to time, you'll get a cute animation of a unicorn or a narwhal or some other creature, which is just, it just adds a bit of magic. So the calendar view in Asana makes much more sense. The color coding stands out a lot more and you can simply complete a task then and there and not have it disappear into the abyss. It stays there, which lets you refer back to it at a glance if you need to. You can have checklists within Trello's cards, but there's so much more functionality with Asana subtasks, which operate on pretty much the same principle. The power of tasks and different attributes extends to the subtasks in Asana as well. But it doesn't in Trello. In Trello, this is a simple checklist and you cannot really go in depth with these items, but in Asana, you can still do everything to your subtasks as you would to the main tasks. The basic version of Asana gets you a really long way. You can build up a lot of functionalities within your boards on Trello with their power-ups, but you can only have one attached to your board in the free plan, and it's quite limiting. I feel like you have a lot more flexibility within the Asana's free plan. And as for the little bonus that I promised at the very beginning, you can actually make Asana a bit more visual too. So first of all, you can add images to tasks to have a lovely cover displayed in the board view. And this can be done as easily in Asana as it is in Trello. You just go to your tasks in the board view, you click on that paperclip in the top right corner, attach a file, so an image in that case, from your computer, Dropbox, Google Drive, whichever one you choose. And once that's attached, you have that cover on your board view. And it's just that simple. And there's also an option to add background to your board, just like you would in Trello. And I know a lot of people were missing that functionality from Asana, but it is there, it's just a bit more hidden. And this can be done from your settings. So you go to your profile by clicking on the photo in the top right corner, you click My Profile Settings, go to the Display tab, then you have an option down below to add a background. So you've got a default one, Aqua, Timber, Valley, blah, blah. There is a bit more of a limit to it. And the thing is, with Trello, of course, you could add different backgrounds to different boards. But with this one, you only have one image per all of your boards that display on your profile. It is a bit of a drawback, but in any case, if you're trying to make Asana a bit more visual and make it a bit more kind of pretty for yourself, this is how you do it. So to sum up, I think Asana is much better because it has the same functionalities as Trello, plus so much more. It's arguably more satisfying and user-friendly, it's much easier to manage multiple projects at the same time, and it has a lot of Trello's functionalities, but more and much more adaptable for your and your team's needs. But I'd love to hear from you. Which one are you using? Do you prefer Trello or Asana? And what functionalities are you missing in one or the other? If you like this video, check out my How to Set Up Asana video, which I made just for you. It will show you how easy it actually is and help you set everything up quickly to start managing your projects in there straight away. Like this video if you enjoyed it, comment below which platform you prefer, and make sure to subscribe to my channel for super actionable ideas for content creation. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.